In my opinion, this is murder. It's not an accident because they knew that the danger existed. You have absolutely clueless people running civil aviation, either the minister or the DGCA. There was no way that you can push anything with the government because the civil aviation is controlled by the government, whether it's DGCA or airport authority or airlines. So, and no one is held accountable. If we have given a report saying it's positively dangerous 9 years back and 20 lives are lost today, now who's going to be held accountable? You know, they will just blame the pilots. And then they'll sweep the rest of the things under the carpet. So unless some heads roll, and it's not that you wait for an inquiry to find out. Now, the fact is, like even last year, the DGCA's flagged Calicut safety. Now, if the DGCA's flagged it 1 year back in their audit, and an accident takes place more than a year later, now, who is accountable? It is also the DGCA because he is licensing the airport. If you're not happy with the safety standards of an airport, why did you license? You can suspend the license of an airport. It's only if you cancel an airline license or an airport license will they even act to improve safety. Here, lives are cheap. Lives are cheap. You just give 20 lakhs or 5 lakhs or whatever, and then you write off and you all live happily ever after. See, that's what happens here. And you'll find the same Babu will probably get a promotion and go somewhere. See, you have absolutely clueless people running civil aviation, either the minister or the DGCA. They're all clueless, you know, and they have corrupt. And I've been pointing this out even 10 years back, that the corruption level in civil aviation is very high. And that is why people get away with murder. In my opinion, this is murder. It's not an accident because they knew that the danger existed. Even their own audits have flagged the safety issues. And if they continue to sweep things under the carpet, you know, I would say that you fly only on horoscope. You don't fly on safety. See, I've not studied it in detail, but all I can say is, if you're landing on runway 10, which is where the crash is taking place, he's landed with a tailwind. You know, tailwind in wet conditions, poor braking, you're asking for trouble. So I really cannot understand why such an experienced pilot attempted that. And the only thing I can think of is that he must have been under extreme fatigue, because it's only under fatigue that you tend to take wrong decisions. And airlines and DGCA don't seem to understand that word at all, because I was told, it's not confirmed, that Air India Express had asked for dispensation to extend the duty time to operate this flight, and the DGCA has given a blanket clearance. So if that is true, that they have given a blanket clearance to Air India Express to extend duty time without a fatigue risk assessment, it's a criminal offense. See, like, you can talk of severe rain, but if there was very, very heavy rain, the visibility cannot be 2,000 meters. Yes, it must have been raining earlier, but the reported visibility was 2,000. Quite possible that he has landed when the microburst would have taken place. But when he couldn't land from the east towards the west, it really beats me how he even attempted to land from the other side, which any pilot knows is dangerous. And unless there is pressure, and you know, even in the Mangalore crash, we know that the captain was pressurized. So you will have to look at the training standards of that airline which is very questionable. But even an experienced pilot under fatigue is bound to make a mistake. The financial stress is a big factor. The COVID is a big factor. And when you're operating under stress and you do not have, feel like you need a leader. Now, in all cases, you will find that where maybe the leadership is good, even under stress, the others will work well. You really don't know what is the working condition in airlines like Air India Express or others in the present circumstance. So I would really worry about how fatigue and stress will play a part.